You guys ever done something stupid and you look back now and say, what in the hell was I thinking? Now that I have kids, I want to tell them, don't do anything stupid. Don't do what I did. You know, you don't want them to do exactly the things that you did growing up. Now, I didn't do anything criminal or anything, just stupid. Just when I look back and I'm like, dude, you're a freaking idiot. You're right. I was telling actually a buddy of mine a couple of weeks ago about a story, and he said the same thing. He's like, why did you do that? And I'm like, I don't know. I can't explain it. I just did it. You know, and I'm going to give you a couple of these stories I did. And, you know, it's nothing bad. I just think they're funny. When I was younger, and I had a, you know, we were still friends to this day. I had a bunch of friends of mine, and we had this bright idea. Let's get a party van. And said van was this, basically this Ford utility van with no windows whatsoever. And our big goal in life was like, and this is when we were in high school, and our big goal in life was like, every Friday night we'll go to the football games, we'll all pile in, we'll get drunk, we'll have fun, we'll pick up chicks, all this stuff. Brilliant, right? So this is 17-year-old mind thinking. So, you know, we go out and we all throw our funds in and get this beat up piece of shit van. And then one of my friends, we ended up painting it and putting logos on it and all this stuff. Well, one of the logistical problems with the van, knowing that we're going to be imbibing in some beverages of our choice, there was no indoor plumbing. So we kind of had to improvise. We had the brilliant idea to get a drill and drilled a big ass hole in the back of the van. And then we took a big funnel, you know, like a funnel you'd put in your for your lawnmower, you know, like when you're changing the oil and stuff. We'd use it, no issues, worked great. You know, the only problem is when you're actually driving, it's kind of hard to take a piss when you're all over the place. But I digress. The problem was, and this van only lasted for 6 months because our parents finally got involved and said, oh, the hell, we are not leaving this piece of crap in my house, and you're paying for all the insurance. Anyway, so the van ended up leaving, but we had to clean the van. So once we went and actually cleaned the van, and for those of you that have like cats or dogs, you can relate to this. We had like shag carpet. So we had the shag carpet on the actual base. That brilliant idea to put the carpet down. Well, the carpet wasn't coming up too easy. And I know why. Because it was freaking saturated in piss. So we had to peel that off. And when we peeled it off, it was the worst smell ever. I mean, imagine like having 30 cats in your house and it's never been clean. And all of a sudden you pull back a carpet and there's piss stains everywhere. Nastiest thing ever. So that was the stupidest thing I did from a van standpoint. All right, some other stories. One of us had the bright idea to get a fire extinguisher and clear said fire extinguisher of the flame retardant crap in it, sprayed it out. And we decided we were going to pressurize it with something, a liquid. And we're going to pressurize it with water. So I have the ultimate freaking water gun, right? I mean, I thought it was cool as shit. I mean, once we got it in there, put half water in, I think we pressurized it with half air. And that thing would, I mean, it would shoot all, I mean, this thing was a rocket, like a freaking water cannon. It was awesome. Well, we had this bright idea. We went through a drive-thru, and we were very parched at the time, and we decided that we'd like four waters, so we went up to the drive-thru at the poor lady at McDonald's or Burger King, wherever it was, and we'd like four waters, please. And she said, of course, no problem. We pull up to the, you know, the window and everything, and she's like, here you go. And we're like, no, here's your water, and we sprayed her, and we freaking took off. We got the hell out of there. Now, we ended up getting caught. And we got in so much trouble with our parents and, you know, but I feel, and here's the thing. Well, it was a piss poor decision. It was freaking assault, if you think about it. Worst thing ever. I regret to this day doing that. Every time I see a fire extinguisher, I think of that poor girl. I mean, we had to traumatize the damn thing. I mean, think about it. I mean, she's sitting here giving us the waters, getting ready for the next Big Mac or the freaking Whopper. And all of a sudden, get sprayed with water. I mean, can you imagine? uncool as hell that we did that. Now, it was funny at the time, but not cool. So these are those things like I tell my kids, don't you ever freaking do this. Because if I saw that girl today, I would kiss her freaking ass and say, I am so sorry, please forgive me that we even thought we did that. And one other one, I'll give you one more. And this, I progressed a little bit in age, so I got more mature after I got out of high school by, you know, I think it was my sophomore or junior year. Yeah, it was my sophomore because I was still living in a dorm. And had a day of school, went out to school, and after school, we decided we needed to go get a couple beverages at the local tavern. Well, later that night, I had a meeting. So I had a meeting that I had to be for a professor at like 9 o'clock p.m., but I said, okay, I got plenty of time. So we ended up drinking, having a happy hour, got tipsy, and I was like, oh, I got plenty of time. Ended up getting, let's just say, drunk. So as I came home, and remember, I hadn't shaved in like 2 or 3 days, and this was an important meeting. So I had to meet with this professor that evening and come back to my dorm, stumbled up there, figured I'd get in the shower, but I was late, so I didn't have time to take a shower. I was like, okay, I can shave. Well, problem was, I didn't have any freaking shaving cream. I didn't have any soap. I didn't have anything to basically shave with. My roommate was gone. I couldn't even ask him. I was looking around, nothing. I was like, shit, I gotta freaking shave at least. Present myself a little bit. I hadn't taken a shower. I was probably smelling like alcohol. At least I could brush my teeth. So I look around and you know, in the dorms, you know, they don't have full size refrigerators. They have, you know, like those little mini ones. So anyway, I'm, looking around and I see my roommate's little mini fridge. So I go over to it, open it up. You know, I don't know why I was looking at it. I was drunk at the time. I really didn't know. And I see a condiment. And said condiment was Miracle Whip. Well, I had this bright idea that I could use Miracle Whip as a shaving cream. And sure as shit or not, I put that shit all over my face, lathered myself up, and that thing worked like a charm. I had no idea that Miracle Whip could be substituted as a shaving cream. Unbelievable. And it was smooth too. I mean, my face was kind of tangy and I smelled good afterwards, but damn, if you're ever in a pinch and you need shaving cream and you don't have anything to use, grab some freaking condiments, grab some ketchup, grab some mayonnaise, grab some mustard, take it right off. Work like a charm. All right, guys, if you have any funny stories, please share them with them. Do a response video. Have fun with this. I mean, we only live once. I did some stupid shit, and I'm like, what in the hell was I thinking? But I'm hoping my kids won't follow my path. Nothing bad, but I still thought they were funny. I got to find that girl and apologize to her. All right, guys, be good, and I'll talk to you soon.